A little something for cuffing season. For all them fools out there that got it bad right now. Can't say I don't, but you know what? I'm a different type of motherfucker. That's what it is at the end of the day. I'm a different type of motherfucker. I'm a different breed, cut from a different cloth. I can have it bad and not give no fucks at the end of the day because I got money to make. Money to make, motherfucking empires to build and shit. A CEO life. You already know what it is. Y'all know what to do. But, shit, man. We out here. Damn, now we got two of these fucking people with their taxis out here. Wonder if it's going to be a taxi fight, y'all. I don't know. They say it's the rival cab company, and I hear rival. I get back to my street shit like, fuck a rival. Real shit about to be on that jail mentality. About to be sticking fools and shit. Man. They really just posted, though. Like, it was just the one dude from the rival cab company. Now they got a second car. He got on the phone and was looking at me all hard. Now they got a second car up here. Oh, shit. It might go down tonight, y'all. I hope it doesn't. Oh, now this guy want to go in and say that he's here after I already went in and talked to the people and said that I was here. Haters. Hating ass cab companies, man. That's what I'm saying. This competition gets ruthless out in this motherfucker sometimes. At least from what I've seen on my last couple of Tuesdays and shit. Fucking bored as hell right now. Bored as hell, wishing we had more music and shit. But, you know what? We about to turn on the FM. Fuck it. About to turn on the FM. What's up? TikTok. Yeah, I hear accosting people. Dude, I hear accosting my customers. Let's see. Let's see how this works out tonight, y'all. Shit. Man, but yeah, let's get this FM cracking for y'all. Sometimes this motherfucker wants to work in this fucking cab. Other times, I don't know. Let's see if we can get this thing to work. You know what's fucked up is the stereo will not want to work. Now I'll be driving, it kicks on randomly, scares the fuck out of me every time. Oh, there we go.
Forget me.
Oh my God, something was just brought to my attention, y'all. We have to talk on this one. This shit was just brought to my attention. There is someone on Instagram selling these fucking things right now. Enjoy your partner. Spark it up with some excitement. You'll be thankful. It's a vibrator that like attaches to the vagina. This shit just sits on there like under the panties and shit. Looks like it's got like a little scoop or something underneath it. Yeah, it's got some weird shit where it just like hooks up to the vagina. And then you press a button, it's got a remote. Boy, that's better than a TV remote. Man. I need a universal remote, and I need a list of everyone that's got one of those, because I'm just going to drive past their house and hit that shit randomly one day. And that'd be fucked up. Broads being there cooking dinner and shit, all of a sudden they just start fucking leaking all over the place, creaming their jeans. Man, that's some fucked up shit. It's so that other people can control the settings on it. Would you really want, like, I don't know, I mean, it's one thing to have someone, like, holding a vibrator and putting it inside you and fucking you with it, but do you really want someone having remote access to your shit like that? That takes some trust right there. I mean, even if you trust the person, that's just, because there's assholes like me that, like I said, I would just randomly press it just for fun sometimes. Wouldn't even be trying to get nothing cracking, just press it just to press it. Just press that button, make a chick orgasm randomly. She'd be on the phone with her grandparents calling for Thanksgiving or some shit. And I'll just be like, press the button. Why is this motherfucker sitting here still? Man, I just look over and now all of a sudden the taxis have moved closer and they're like kind of surrounding my cab. It's about to go down. You know what? I need to make a CEO-branded fucking version of these fucking remote control vibrators. We gotta think of a name for them, though. Not no remote control vibrators. We gotta call it, like, the Pussy Crusher 1000. Some crazy shit like that. The Pussy Crusher 1000. That's what we'll call it. I'm going to figure out a way to get these made with my logo on them, y'all. Just wait. This Christmas, it's coming. Best gift you can give to your wife or your wife's sister. Or just the random broad you fucking with down the street. Just the neighborhood strawberries, even. It's the season of giving, y'all. Give the gift that keeps on giving with the Pussy Crusher 1000. That sounds like a good-ass slogan, huh? And it really is the gift that keeps on giving. Shit, let's see what this FM got cracking now. Hottest station on the dial, the CEO show. It's that shit right there. We just got our first call. It's on and cracking, y'all. Just got our first call for the broadcast. So we're gonna go ahead and get it moving and get it cracking here. We'll make sure to give this rival cab company the finger on my way out, though. Some old people at the nursing home. Let's see what. But I'm wondering, who's getting picked up at the nursing home at damn near 2 in the morning is what I'm wondering. Old people probably fucking lit right now. Hopefully it's another one that wants to go look for some pussy. Because I'm not going to lie, I've been driving around town since that night. Just in case that situation ever came up again, I've been scouting out spots to find it. Just pussy for old people. That's going to be my good deed for the holiday season. I'm going to help old guys get some fucking poonanner. We heading over here to the Hearthstone Nursing and Rehabilitation Center. See what kind of fun this fucking trip's gonna be. Should be there in about 8 minutes, so we're gonna go ahead and for those of y'all that keep hearing that beeping, that's just my GPS, y'all. Don't be alarmed. Everything is good. We're about to get on the 5 South here, on the I-5 freeway here. I swear to God, this time of night, man, it's like the Walking Dead and shit out here with these homeless people. These tweakers be looking like the fucking zombies on that show, The Walking Dead, I swear to God. Just randomly stumbling around. Except for instead of brains, they just feed on meth. But you know what? I always thought that that's going to be like our Resident Evil zombie apocalypse right there. Like, it's not going to be like in the movies, of course, where fucking... Because, I don't know, this is my little theory on it. Maybe I'm just weird. So we have all these fucking movies that predict things, but it doesn't ever happen exactly how it's supposed to fucking... how it actually happens. And that's where people get skeptical and say, oh, the movie didn't predict it, or the TV show didn't predict it. No, the TV shows and movies, they're predicting the shit for us and telling what's going to happen, but you got to read between the lines. It ain't going to be exactly like in the fucking movie. They can't just give you that kind of information. Then it would just be too fucking weird. So they're going to go ahead and make it to where, like they'll have Resident Evil and they're fucking, the whole plot is a zombie apocalypse because the virus takes over. They don't tell you that the virus... it's just the new drugs that are coming out. We got the meth, the bath salts, the motherfucking bath salts for making motherfucker zombies. Hella people. There was that guy, or he was on, was he on bath salts or spice? There was a